The Maldives, a paradise of more than 1,200 islands scattered across the Indian Ocean, is facing a crisis unlike any other. Its turquoise lagoons, white sand beaches, and vibrant coral reefs attract millions every year. Yet rising sea levels now threaten to swallow much of the land. For the Maldives, climate change is not a distant problem. It is an immediate threat. The question facing the nation is staggering. Can massive engineering projects save it from disappearing beneath the waves? The islands are breathtaking, but life here is far from easy. Malay, the capital, is one of the most densely populated cities in the world, with more than 200,000 people packed into just 5 square kilometers. Buildings cram the shoreline, fresh water is scarce, and infrastructure struggles to keep up with the demands of a growing population. The government already spends nearly a third of its national budget on climate adaptation, constructing seawalls, reclaiming land, and reinforcing the coast. Yet these measures barely scratch the surface. Rising seas, stronger storms, and warming oceans threaten to overwhelm the nation's efforts. Coral bleaching, coastal erosion, and saltwater intrusion into freshwater reserves are accelerating, threatening not just homes and tourism, but the very foundations of the island's ecosystems. The Maldives faces an existential challenge that demands solutions far beyond conventional planning, requiring both visionary engineering and careful environmental management. In response, the Maldives has turned to an extraordinary vision, the first ever floating city. Designed to host 5,000 homes, hotels, shops, a mosque, and even football fields, the project reimagines life on water. Its layout takes inspiration from honeycombs and brain coral, reflecting the delicate ecosystems that surround the islands. Roads stretch for 16 kilometers, but only bikes and electric buggies are allowed, preserving the city's sustainability and tranquility. The floating city is not just about creating space, it is about resilience. Each structure will be built on steel stilts anchored deep into the seabed, designed to rise and fall with the tides and withstand cyclones and waves. Modular construction techniques will allow new neighborhoods to be added incrementally, providing flexibility for future growth. The idea was championed by Mohammed Nasheed, a former president and climate activist who envisioned a city that could adapt to rising seas and serve as a model for other low-lying nations. Dutch engineers from Docklands brought decades of floating infrastructure experience, having developed floating neighborhoods and ports across the Netherlands, one of the world's most flood-prone nations. Yet questions remain. How affordable will these homes be for locals? Will foreign investment dominate the city? And how will dredging and artificial reefs affect the surrounding marine environment? Environmental considerations have been at the forefront of design. Light must reach coral beneath floating platforms, and water flow must remain unimpeded to prevent stagnation. Engineers are exploring ways to integrate artificial reefs beneath the city to provide new habitats for fish and marine life, turning the project into both a human and ecological experiment. The floating city is as much a laboratory as it is a community, testing the limits of engineering in harmony with nature. The floating city project was unveiled in 2021 with a prototype called First Island, giving a glimpse of modular homes, community spaces, and advanced water management systems. The design includes renewable energy integration, wastewater recycling, and desalination units to ensure a self-sufficient community. But as of 2025, large-scale construction remains limited, casting doubt on the ambitious 2027 completion target. Financing remains a major hurdle, with a mix of public funds and private investment needed to cover the tens of billions required. Logistical challenges, from transporting heavy construction modules to anchoring them securely in the lagoon, add another layer of complexity. Yet the vision continues to capture global attention. The floating city is more than a construction project. It is a statement of human ambition against the forces of nature. Alongside the floating city, the Maldives is pursuing another mega project, the Maldives International Financial Center. With an $8.8 billion investment and international partnerships, The plan envisions a tax-free offshore hub for banking, corporate services, and cryptocurrency. Built on reclaimed land extending from Hulhumalay, the hub will include 3 high-rise towers, a convention center, retail and residential areas, schools, and museums. Officials project it could contribute $1 billion annually to the nation's $7 billion GDP, diversifying an economy heavily reliant on tourism. The target launch is set for 2030, demonstrating the Maldives' commitment to bold, forward-looking solutions that blend economic growth with innovation. The hub is also designed with climate resilience in mind, with elevated structures, storm surge defenses, and green spaces to mitigate flooding risks. Not all projects float or reach skyward. Bridges are reshaping life across the archipelago. The Sinimalay Bridge, completed in 2018, links Malay to the airport, drastically reducing travel time and stimulating trade and tourism. The Thillimalay Bridge, currently under construction, will span 6 kilometers at a cost of $500 million, connecting more islands to the capital and improving access to essential services. In the south, new bridges in Adu City are linking islands previously isolated, opening opportunities for commerce and tourism. These projects may seem conventional, but for a country scattered across hundreds of islands, they are transformative. They reduce reliance on ferries, improve emergency access during storms, and integrate remote communities into the national economy. Tourism remains the lifeblood of the Maldives, and large-scale developments continue to push boundaries. Luxury resorts are under construction on remote atolls, offering experiences that blend natural beauty with futuristic design. The Zamani Islands Resort, set to open in 2026, will feature a super yacht marina, an underwater restaurant, and villas suspended over lagoons. By 2029, Samana Ocean Views, a $600 million resort backed by international developers, will further cement the Maldives' reputation as a global luxury destination. At the same time, Valana International Airport is undergoing a $1 billion expansion, set to complete in 2025, increasing capacity to 7 million passengers annually. Each project demonstrates the country's strategy: modernize infrastructure while safeguarding the economic engine of tourism. These developments are also designed with climate adaptation in mind, incorporating elevated walkways, seawalls, and energy-efficient technologies to reduce environmental impact. Yet the stakes could not be higher. The Maldives stands at the forefront of climate change, its future literally at sea level. Floating cities, bridges, and financial hubs offer hope and innovation, but they carry risk. Disruption to delicate ecosystems, high costs, and social inequality could undermine the resilience these projects aim to create. The Maldives is testing the limits of engineering, showing what is possible when survival is on the line. These megaprojects may define the future not only of this island nation, but of low-lying countries worldwide. Will they save the Maldives? Or are they only buying time against the rising tide? For now, the nation remains a proving ground for human creativity, ambition, and the unthinkable feats that may be needed to adapt to a changing world. The Maldives is more than a paradise, it is a living laboratory for how engineering can confront climate change and rethink life on water. Its story is one of resilience, innovation, and the determination to survive against the odds.